In this video, we are going to compare the various types of biodigesters that we construct for homeowners in this part of the world. I'm in the business of biodigester construction and consultation. I've been documenting my journey over the years, and on this channel, I simply show you how to construct a simple on-site biodegradable toilet biodigester. We do have various types of biodigesters that we construct for homeowners in Ghana, and particularly on this channel, we have shown the various types of biodigesters that we do have constructed. A successful biodigester construction involves two things: the type of facility for an estimated users, and then the possible location of the facility. There will be several methods of constructing biodegradable toilet waste biodigester. And in this video, we are going to consider the various methods that are available to you and which one you must use for any particular type of construction. Let's get into the video now. The first method is the use of blocks for biodigester construction. With this method, it's simple. You are using blocks to do the construction, and the kind of blocks do not really matter. It usually depends on what is available to you when at the site of construction. I prefer quarry dust blocks, but any type of block will work for you. Some even use bricks for this type of construction. And with this construction, you are considering basically the block work, you are considering the inside layout, and of course, you are considering the top layer. We are also considering the size of the digester, knowing that the blocks can be 5 inches, can be 6 inches, it can be 4 inches. Some of them are even hollow blocks, and they all do work fine, depending on whatever you meet on site. The second method is through the block work. By this time, you have something we call inside soak away for a possible step down for the leachate pipe to be connected into a bigger drainage system that's available to you on site. There are situations whereby you are constructing a biodigester and what you meet on site is not what you like. That's not the preferable means of constructing the digester. The inlet pipe that's coming from the house is too low, so you are not going to be able to match the pipe, the outlet pipe, to, let's say you are giving it to a gutter or a drainage system. What it means is that you might have to do a small size soak away in the biodigester itself, and then have it given a step up whereby the pipe then will be connected to go to the drainage system. In simple terms, some of the water might have to get stuck in the digester in that particular soak away, and then you have to filter that water slowly through the gutter. You are going to leave some of the water there until the water gets to that level before it can flow. So it's basically like an overflow pipe whereby the wastewater just simply overflows its bank and then goes into the gutter. In that situation, you might need charcoal and some small chippings to do the filtration for that particular water before it goes into the gutter. The third method for biodigester construction is also famous. Over here in Ghana, this is one of the best ways of constructing biodigesters because it has helped a lot of people to scale their business. 2 or 3 or even 4 biodigesters can be done in a day. And that's the use of prefabricated slabs or precast slabs. As the name suggests, we use already cast prefab slabs. This means that these slabs have been done off-site and then they are brought on site for the construction when the time is up. These precast slabs became a game changer for us biodigester constructors here in Ghana because of the turnaround time for the biodigester construction in which it provides the business owners. These are slabs that have already been done. They have been cast and they are on site. Whenever you do get a job, you just show up, have the truck pick them up, and then you go on site and then you fix them. You have the inside porous or the pervious concrete as part, and then you have your bedding material as part of this construction. There's not much difference between it, just that this one means that everything has been laid down already for you, and within 3 or 4 hours, you are done with your construction, and then you are gone. This is a channel dedicated to the construction of biodigesters and for homeowners who are interested in DIYing their own biodigester construction. It's a channel that we think is going to help improve the waste management situation in Africa by doing it sustainably. We have subscribers in Nigeria, Kenya, South Africa, all the way to India. So if you are new to the channel and it's the first time here, go ahead and be part of a growing community of biodigester lovers. You can like this video, You can subscribe. If you do have a question, leave it in the comment section below and I'll get back to you on that particular one. The next biodigester construction method, which is a combination of both blocks and the precast slabs, is something that was designed by myself and my team after going through several of this biodigester construction. It's what we have termed as the hybrid type of biodigester construction. The hybrid comes basically from the motor or the car industry, whereby they do have hybrid cars, which uses part fuel and part electricity. And certain times, you have to combine the blocks and the precast slabs just for your biodigester construction. When we say hybrid biodigesters, what we are talking is that we are putting the precast slabs on blocks. And the main reason for such construction is because you show up on site and what you meet on site does not meet the requirement for a biodigester to be constructed. A plumber might have hidden the pipes or the footing of the building will be too low, whereby the pipes, the 4-inch pipes that are coming from the toilets are hidden underground. So it means that you might have to try to match those pipes to the inlet of your biodigester. That means the only option available to you is to elevate the digester to a level whereby the pipes will come inside, still give you enough room at the base of the digester for your bedding material, and still do your biodegradation process for you. And this is what we call the hybrid method.
After the assessment and everything has been done, you come to the realization that you are going to use prefabricated slabs. It's only 2 feet. That's the length. The only option left for you is to have a block work done at the base of the digester before erecting or placing the slabs on it, which will give you a level that you need enough to get the gradient and then the final outlook of the house to match with it. So what the constructor is doing is he realized that the space is not enough. So he needs to level it up and get enough space.
This is a channel dedicated to the construction of biodegradable toilet with biodigesters and for homeowners who are interested in DIYing their own biodigester construction. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe and be part of this growing community of biodigester lovers here in Africa. We have a strong community in Nigeria. We have a strong community in Kenya, Uganda, Botswana, as far as Africa, and in other parts of the continent. We are keen on changing the narrative of waste management right here in Africa, and this is our drive on this channel. So just be part of us and let's succeed together. In all this construction, you have your black water treatment options available to you. We do have the various types of black water treatment options for biodigester construction. The soak-o pits, the soak-away, the traditional soak-away is there, the drainage system connecting to a drainage system, the overflow system, and then of course the filtration system, enhanced filtration, where either you are using the wastewater for your gardening purposes or you are just letting it out into a bigger drainage system. The next video showing on the channel is going to explain to you in further details how to construct a biodigester and construct it for your dream house.